We're talking about different ways to treat post-traumatic stress disorder aside from your traditional types of treatment.
So one of the things that we've started doing is introducing a procedure to these patients who suffer from PTSD as well as trauma. Dr. Rao, can you tell us exactly what a stellate ganglion block is?
Sure. So a stellate ganglion block has been around in the anesthesia pain toolbox for quite some time for patients who have difficult neuropathic or nerve pain conditions that affect the face or the arm. Complex regional pain syndrome, or RSD, is a type of condition that we've used stellate ganglion blocks to treat for a very long time. What we have found in that treatment is that patients who also have those types of chronic pain conditions also developed anxiety and PTSD-like symptoms. It's been shown through multiple studies that PTSD does respond to stellate ganglion blocks.
Well, how is that? How does one relate to the other?
It's a great question. It's a question we get asked often. How does a stellate ganglion injection actually affect the brain and change these types of PTSD-related symptoms? Well, traditionally, when we used to do stellate ganglion blocks for complex regional pain syndrome, the idea was we were going to anesthetize and block this specific set of nerves in the throat area that sends signals up to the brain. Block it, and almost as if when your device goes on the fritz, you power it down, you turn it on, turn it off, you reset it, you reboot it. So the idea is by rebooting the brain, pain should get better. The same type of thinking, when we reboot the brain and those specific parts of the brain that are over-amplified or overexcited, overstimulated, that relay these PTSD-related symptoms, if we can block those parts of the brain and allow them to reset, we can get better control of those PTSD-related symptoms.
Well, with the effects of the procedure, how fast will that take effect? Will it be immediate, or is it something that they will have to wait a couple of days to see if it was beneficial?
With the variability with between different patients and every type of procedure, it can vary. So we have had patients who get better within minutes. We have had patients where it takes a couple of weeks for things to set in. And I usually caution patients and say, this is a procedure that will likely take a week or two or so to get you better. If you get better sooner, wonderful. But don't get discouraged, because it can take a couple of weeks to kick in.
So how does one go about finding us on the internet saying this is something that I might be able to benefit from? How do I get on the schedule? How do I be part of this?
So we've got information, and part of what we're trying to do is educate people. Unfortunately, not many healthcare providers or patients even recognize that stellate ganglion blocks are a reasonable option to treat PTSD-related symptoms. So what we're trying to do is go out there and educate providers, so behavioral mental health providers, physical health or primary care physicians, and let them know that there's alternatives to your traditional types of treatment. Getting online, there's information. There's more and more information that's coming out online being published in support of using stellate ganglion blocks for PTSD treatment. You can look at our websites, you can contact us directly, and we can talk about educating you and giving you some more information about how you may benefit from this treatment.
And appropriate candidates would be, are they only like military, like first line?
So a lot of our patients are veterans, people who have been exposed to some type of traumatic event. However, it's not limited to just those types of people. PTSD is unfortunately significantly underdiagnosed and undertreated in this country. And the nice thing about where we are now is the prevalence and the resources that people are putting towards mental health conditions continue to grow. And by doing so, we're now able to educate more providers that there are other types of treatments. So really, anyone who suffers from any type of PTSD may be a candidate. This is obviously not a first-line treatment. We wouldn't say, hey, if you have some type of trauma that you're dealing with, let's do this injection right out of the bat. We want to make sure that you've done some counseling, tried some medication, seen a psychiatrist, gone through what we would consider conservative treatment. And if those types of treatments do not work or haven't worked enough, then this is a reasonable next step?
Well, I would like to introduce a patient of ours who's done a testimonial. She is not military. She's not a first responder, and you'll hear that in her testimony. Did come see us in one of our offices, and she is just very, very excited about her results.
So if you could just kind of tell us your story a little bit.
Sure. That is actually one of the things that I think was the biggest roadblock for me getting to some treatment and healing. I grew up with the idea that PTSD was just something that happened to veterans. I mean, war combat veterans, that's all I knew. I never even really thought until 9/11 about first responders, honestly. And then just as I aged and learned more, my perspective broadened on what PTSD was. When I was finally diagnosed with complex PTSD, and I mean, for, you know, clarity, that's not even technically a diagnosis yet. It's not made it into the DSM yet. But the therapist I was working with at the time told me, there's this thing called complex PTSD. It is not in the DSM yet, but we all know it exists. It's essentially PTSD, but for people who have had maybe smaller traumas, but more of them, and they sort of build up in the system, especially childhood trauma, which is where my complex PTSD came from. You know, growing up, I knew my parents seemed very unfair and that I cried a lot. And as I grew up, I had nightmares about my family all the time. I didn't realize they were night terrors. I didn't realize my tight muscles and constant headaches and stress and, like, you know, IBS, all of these things came from my childhood. And I never took it seriously because I always compared myself to, you know, veterans and thought, well, I don't have anything compared to what they've been through.
Yep, but I think that's part of the, and I think that's why a lot of people are still hiding in the background and thinking, Yes. Well, that's because there's nothing that I did in my life that would warrant this. What were your results from this? I knew that, you know, you went to therapy, and then how did you get to Dr. Rao?
That is a great question. And I think I just also want to comment on what you were just saying about the stigma, because I think there's just so much shame around all of this. I think we, you know, when you grow up in a household like this, you sort of start to figure out that this is probably your fault, even though, you know, later in therapy, you find out it wasn't. So I think we start out young blaming ourselves for how we're being treated. And then that just grows into this shame. Like, I can't get treatment because, you know, it's my fault. And I think that's what stops a lot of us. And also just the, you know, misunderstanding that you have to be seriously traumatized to the point of, you know, having a grenade blow up at you to do damage to your brain. And that's obviously not true. Small traumas build up over time. So there's that. But yeah, I've done years of therapy, and it wasn't really until my most recent therapist, where she had me read a book called The Body Keeps the Score. And it talks about how, yeah, you have anxiety, you'll have depression, you'll have these things, but it's a much bigger picture than that, because all of that trauma has rewired your brain. And it affects your mental health, sure, but it also affects inflammation and your immune system and all of these different things. So I started to realize that therapy wasn't going to fix me. It was going to have to be far more holistic than that. And that's when I found out about this injection. I figured if I'm sort of stuck in fight or flight, no matter how much therapy I do, it's not going to fix the indigestion and the problems with my stomach and, you know, the tight muscles, et cetera. So for me, this was sort of one of the last steps. I did a lot of therapy, and then this was one of the last steps I've taken so far, just to sort of get my body caught up with where my brain is now, if that makes any sense whatsoever.
Unfortunately, it does.
Yeah.
So then you reached out to have this procedure, and I believe that we saw you in one of our other offices. And can you recall that day?
Yes. I you know, I arrived, I was running late, I was having a spaz attack as usual, because I'm very high strung because of all these things. But once I got there, everyone was so nice. And then once I met you, it became a lot easier. But one thing that really struck me was how fast the whole thing was. I somehow thought it would be much more drawn out and painful. I didn't experience pain. I would say there may have been some discomfort during the injection, but nothing significant. And one of the best parts was having you there sort of talking me through it and patting my shoulder and arm, because it is something that I think seems scarier than it actually is. So you are hyped up anxiety wise. So having you guys in there being so gentle and calm really helped me. And I just couldn't believe how quickly it was over. And the other thing that blew me away was that I felt different within minutes.
Different how?
Yeah, that's a great question. The best way I can describe this is that it feels like most of my life, my heart has sort of been beating loudly in my head, sort of this like boom, 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 like blood rushing through my head all the time. That was gone within 2 to 3 minutes of the injection. I don't hear that or feel that at all anymore. Now I am just much calmer on a daily basis.
Well, excellent.
Yeah.
This is why we do what we do. You know, you're speaking to the patient prior to the procedure, and their anxiety or their depression or their PT, they're like a level 10.
Yep.
I'm literally seeing patients sit up from the procedure and just begin crying because it's so profound to them that they no longer have that anxiety in such a quick time. And Dr. Rao is an amazing proceduralist who's been doing this for many, many years. And I've had the honor of working with him for 15 years plus, but making sure that we know that we have this. Now we need to relate to you that we have this. We have you. You are well, you know, taken care of, and you're in great hands.
Yeah. I mean, I definitely had no doubt that I was in great hands, and all of you had a very calming energy about you. So that was very encouraging. So it was just a great experience.
Well, good. Well, would you recommend this to others?
Absolutely. I went for years wishing for some sort of like miracle cure. And I probably have taken every anti-anxiety medication, every antidepressant. None of them ever helped. They all made it worse. And I kept saying, well, why isn't there some quick fix? And obviously, it is more complicated than that. But this was a pretty quick fix for the physical aspects of PTSD. And that goes a long way. I actually just had my first massage yesterday since having the shot, the injection. It was a completely different experience. Like
it was enjoyable, I'm sure.
Yes. Like my muscles usually like fight back really hard. And my massage therapist, who's been working on me for a while, was like, what happened to you? How are you so relaxed? And I said, I have no idea. It's all this. So it has made a massive difference.
I think that, you know, and you commented that I helped you, but my comment back was, I think you helped me as much as I helped. Appreciate that you took time out of your busy schedule to you know, discuss this with us.
Absolutely. And I really appreciate all of you. And I really just hope that this will spread the word to so many people who are suffering, and they know that there are answers out there.
Dr. Rao, what about the patients that are not able to, or they feel as though they're not able to go through a procedure such as that? Are there any other options that we can offer them?
Sure. So, you know, for patients who have anxiety when it comes to needles or types of injections, we can do this procedure under anesthesia. It's MAC anesthesia. It's just basically IV sedation. The procedure itself only takes about a minute and a half to do, but it can be anxiety provoking for some people, and we have the anesthesia team available to be able to sedate people so that they can go through this procedure seamlessly. Now, if people are not candidates for this or feel like they just don't want to go down an injection route, something else that's been very helpful is transcranial magnetic stimulation, or TMS. And TMS has been FDA approved for refractory depression, or basically depression that has not responded to therapy and different types of antidepressants. But we've also seen it work for OCD, anxiety, and PTSD, as well as a handful of different types of painful conditions. So if that's something that people are interested in, they can also reach out and we can also help educate.